He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, let's start with this new variant yet. Do we know yet if it is as dangerous or deadly as the Delta variant?
We don't know. It is definitely more transmissible than the Delta variant. So that's the most disturbing thing. We don't know if it causes more severe disease. We don't know if it results in a higher mortality rate, but it is more easy to transmit.
I think people sometimes wonder, are we going to go down the alphabet? There's going to be a new variant every couple months. Could this extend these COVID restrictions indefinitely?
Well, what's likely to happen is what we've seen already. You're going to have peaks and valleys of this infection until everybody gets immune. And you can only get immune in two ways. One, you take the vaccine. Two, you get COVID. And getting COVID and getting a vaccine, the protection doesn't last forever. So, you know, it's going to just keep happening and happening and happening. And that's what we call endemicity. It's going to end up being sort of like the flu. That's the direction it's going.
Right. And Moderna already saying that they should have a vaccine ready to battle this variant by 2022. So do you see that cycle continuing with new variant approaching and then a new vaccine for it?
Right. So what's going to happen is we're going to find out in the next couple of weeks really how bad this thing is. Is the vaccine going to be protective? Fortunately, the earliest reports, now they're all anecdotal, are that the people that got infected with this who were vaccinated had a pretty mild course. We don't know about the unvaccinated ones yet. The data is just coming in now. We're going to find out about that. You know, we'll see. But, you know, if it's not this variant, there's going to be another variant until we get everybody immune.
All right, let's get to some viewer questions. This person says, if vaccinated, is there a test to tell if you have had COVID? I'm hearing the antibody test will be positive just from the vaccine.
Well, there's two kinds of antibodies that can be tested commercially. The spike protein, which is what you develop after you get the vaccine, and the nucleocapsid protein, which has nothing to do with the vaccine. And you can actually have that ordered. You can have a nucleocapsid antibody test ordered, and that will tell you whether you've had COVID in the past or not. That exists.
Hmm. All right.
All right, another question here. If my nieces ages 12, 11, and 7 are not vaccinated, is it safe to have them over at my house for Christmas? We are all vaccinated.
This is the wrong year for that question. Sorry, it's not safe. It is not safe to mix unvaccinated people with vaccinated people at this point. This is only getting worse, as we've just been talking about. Now, these kids could get vaccinated. And if they get vaccinated soon, they should have enough immunity, you know, so that you can actually meet together.
All right, next question. What test do you use to determine a variant to a virus with no known isolation sample?
Well, if you don't have the sample, you're not going to be able to do it. You have to have the sample at this particular point in time anyway to actually determine whether you've got a variant or not. It's called genetic sequencing. It's like a resistance test that we do for other viruses and bacteria. And it's not a real easy test, but many places can ultimately do it.
All right. Thanks, Dr. Murphy. If you didn't get your question answered, the doctor answers them biweekly at Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email or head to our Morning News Facebook page. Post one there. We'll talk to him again on Friday. Thanks a bunch.
Okay. Have a great week.
You too.